Now next, in this video we are going to study about parts of flower. So I hope you can recall different parts of flower. It's very easy. So as we know that flower is modified shoot. Flower is modification of shoot, mean for sexual reproduction. Flower is formed only for sexual reproduction. Okay, so flower is modification of shoot. Shoot consists of what? Leaves and stain, isn't it? Shoot consists of leaves and stain. So here in flower, leaves are modified to form calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. While stain, it is modified to form such thalamus or receptacle. Thalamus or receptacle, okay? So calyx, corolla, these are known as accessory whorls, okay, or non-essential whorls, while androecium, gynoecium are known as essential whorls, okay? Because calyx and corolla are not directly involved in sexual reproduction. Androecium and gynoecium are directly involved in sexual reproduction. They are directly participating in sexual reproduction. So here, four whorls are there, calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium. Whorl means they are having cyclic arrangement on thalamus. So outermost whorl is calyx. An individual member is known as sepal, which are green in color. The inner two calyx, that is corolla. Individual member is called as petal, which are colorful, fragrant, helps to attract insects. Now inner two corolla, there is androecium. Individual member of androecium is known as stamen. Then innermost is gynoecium or pistil. An individual member is known as carpel. So thus, calyx, it is outermost whorl, green in color. Individual member is sepal. Inner two calyx, there is a corolla inner. Then individual member is petal, which are colorful, fragrant, helps to attract insects. In inner two corolla, there is androecium. Individual member is called stamen. So there may be many stamens. So androecium, what is function of androecium? It produces pollen grains. And innermost whorl is gynoecium or pistil. Individual member is called carpel. And what is function of gynoecium? It produces that female spores. Okay. So this is about different parts of flower. Next, we will study about anthers of anther and details. Now, next whorl is, we are going to study about details of anther. Okay, stamen consists of this filament and this one is anther. So, mostly anthers have two lobes, 1, 2. So such an anther having two lobes is called as bilobed anther. So mostly anther is bilobed, known as dithecous anther. Bilobed anther is known as dithecous anther. In case of hibiscus, there is only one lobe, one kidney shaped lobe is there like this. So this is called as monothecous anther. This one is monothecous anther. This one is dithecous anther. Okay, having two lobes. And many such stamens are present in one flower. What is function of such a stamen? To produce pollen grains. If you take section of such an anther, then it will look like this. Okay. Then initially immature anther will have outermost layer called epidermis. Outermost layer called epidermis, and inner to epidermis there will be only parenchymatous cell, a immature anther. Okay, then after bit that parenchymatous cell will differentiate to form archisporial cell, from which there will be formation of outer protective layers like that of endothecium, middle layer. Okay, and that inner cells will form sporogenous tissue. Okay, so that's from that archisporial cell, outer protective layers are formed, as well as inner sporogenous tissue is formed here. So this outermost layer is epidermis. Now inner to epidermis there is endothecium. This you can see epidermis is common for entire anther. Okay. So in this anther there are two anther lobes and each anther lobe is having 2 to 2 microsporangiums. That means pollen sacs. Okay. So total 4 pollen sacs are there. Total 4 microsporangia are there. Such anther it is called as tetrasporangiate. Tetrasporangiate. Tetra means 4. It is having, as it is having 4 microsporangium, microsporangia or pollen sacs, 1 microsporangium, many microsporangia. As it is having total 4 microsporangia, then it is called as tetrasporangiate. 4 pollen sacs are there. So 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here I have drawn only this much part of this anther. If question is asked in exam, then you have to draw complete diagram. Okay. So this is TS of anther. Outermost layer is epidermis, which gives protection to this anther. Inner to epidermis, there is endothecium. Inner to epidermis, there is endothecium. This endothecium helps in dehiscence of anther, that is rupture of this anther, so that pollen grains can be released from this anther. So this endothecium, it helps in dehiscence of anther or rupture of that anther, so all pollen grains can be released. Inner to this endothecium, there are 1 to 3 layers of middle layer. When anther becomes mature, all these cells of middle layer get separated, they get dissolved and pollen grains from both this pollen sacs get mixed together. Okay. So thus this is middle layer, cells of middle layer get absorbed here, get digested and pollen grains of both these pollen sacs get mixed together. Inner to middle layer there is microsporangia, it is pleurin. So this one is microsporangium that having sporogenous tissue. So in these microsporangium there are microspore mother cells. Okay. And one more important thing, in inner to middle layer there is tapetum. Innermost layer it is tapetum. Epidermis. Inner to epidermis there is endothecium. Inner to endothecium there 1, 2, 3 layer, middle layer. And then innermost layer is tapetum, which surrounds sporogenous tissue. So tapetum, it gives nourishment for developing pollen grain. It is very important, can be asked for MCQ. So tapetum gives nourishment for developing pollen grains. So outermost is epidermis and then endothecium, then middle layer and then tapetum. Inner to tapetum there is sporogenous tissue. And this sporogenous tissue is having large number of microspore mother cells. And each microspore mother cell give rise to microspore tetrad, that means 4 pollen grains are formed from 1 microspore mother cell. Okay, so this sporogenous tissue will have microspore mother cells. 1 microspore mother cell on meiosis produce. Suppose this is 1 microspore mother cell. So this microspore mother cell produce total 4 pollen grains by meiosis. So microspore mother cell produce 4 pollen grains by meiosis. Okay. So thus there are many microspore mother cells are present in each such a pollen sac, which on meiosis produce pollen grains. When this anther become mature, then there is a dehiscence of anther. So this endothecium, it helps in dehiscence of anther and all pollen grains are released out. Okay, so this is about TS of anther having different layers.